and welcome back to The Breakdown. Today I'm going to be teaching you how to start a bucket server in Minecraft 1.14.4. Now, this tutorial says 1.13. When you're watching this video and go to this page, guess what? It's going to be this tutorial here. So that will no longer be there. This is for 1.14.4. We're going to walk you through every step of getting a bucket server set up, and then at the end of the video, I'm going to show you a video that will basically allow you to get plugins on your server, which is, after all, the main benefit of a bucket server is being able to get plugins on your server. So we're going to go through every single step of it today. Until at the end, you have an awesome server with bucket plugins on it. Now, first and foremost, I do want to say that this is not a 24-hour server. It's only up and running when your computer is up and running, and it's only meant for your friends and family, meaning if you want to make a public server that is like available to anyone, you can't do that using this method and be safe about it because it uses your own IP address. With your own IP address, people can find out where you live, they can take your internet offline through a DDoS attack, and many, many other things. On top of that, it does use your own computer's hardware, so if you don't have a pretty good computer, you're not going to be able to run a Minecraft server and play Minecraft with players on that server at the same time. An example is this computer that I have right now has an i7-4770K. Not a bad processor, but not the best anymore. But that processor has no issues except when it's running a Minecraft server with, let's say, 10-15 plugins on it, suddenly it starts to lag a little bit. It starts to like hiccup and things like that. And that's why you need a good computer to be able to run this server. Now, what if you don't have any of these things? What if you want to make a public server? What if you want your friends to be able to join it even when your computer's not running? What if you want to create a server and you don't have a computer to run a server on? Well, guess what? We have a solution for you, and that solution is Apex Minecraft Hosting. Go to the first link down below, thebreakdown.xyz/apex, to get an incredible 24-hour DDoS-protected Minecraft server for you and your friends. We actually love Apex so much that we host our own server on them, play.breakdowncraft.com. So again, if you want a quick and easy way to set up a server for you, your friends, to make a public server, to make a server that's not on your own hardware, it's on Apex's hardware, Apex Minecraft Hosting is the best place to do it. You can check out Apex again at the first link down below, thebreakdown.xyz/apex. Over there, you'll be able to get a server with no worries whatsoever and set it up very, very easily. Nevertheless, let's go ahead and jump right on into this. The first thing you want to do is go to the second link down below, and that's going to take you here. And this is actually our tutorial on starting a bucket server. And if I go too fast at any point in this tutorial, come through and go through this, right? This is a text tutorial. You can go through it at your own pace and all that stuff, but you're watching the video portion. So once you're here, you want to just click on this yellow download bucket button. That will then take you off to a craft bucket download page here, where we want to download the version for 1.14.4. So we're just going to come over here and click on this yellow download button. It takes us finally off to this page where we can click download craft bucket 1.14.4. Once we click on that, it will go ahead and download in the bottom left. It'll then say, do you want to keep this file? As you can see, this type of file can harm a computer. It's not going to harm a computer. As long as it starts with craft bucket and ends in .jar, which ours does, as you can see, craft bucket ends in .jar, we can keep the file. If you're on Mozilla Firefox, you're going to need to save the file in the center of your screen, and the same thing applies. As long as it starts with craft bucket and ends in .jar, you're perfectly fine. Now, at this point, we can go ahead and minimize our browser, and on our desktop, we have a bunch of stuff that I've been working on for our server, play.breakdowncraft.com. So let me just organize the desktop. There we go. We have this file though. This is the craft bucket file. Now, if this isn't on your desktop, no worries. It's in your downloads folder. And you can find that by clicking the Windows icon. It's in the top left for me, but the bottom left of your screen, that little Windows icon in the bottom left, click on that and then type in downloads, right like so. Then you'll have a downloads file folder in Windows. In here, you will find craft bucket, right like that. You can take it and drag it to your desktop just for ease of use. Once craft bucket is on your desktop, we need to go ahead and right click on the desktop, create a new folder, and then we can title that folder whatever we want. In my case, that's going to be play.breakdowncraft.com. Why am I naming it that? Because that is our own Minecraft server. Right there it is. And on that server, you will be able to find Grief Protected Survival. We have a player-based economy survival server with over 100 players online on it every single day. We also have a custom Skyblock server for you and your friends to come play. So come play Medieval Survival in our awesome Skyblock server at play.breakdowncraft.com. That is the IP online every single day. So nevertheless, we're going to go ahead and take craft bucket and drag it into our folder we created here, and then we can open up that folder. Now in this folder, we want to go ahead and right click, create a new text document. So right click, new text document, and then in this new text document, you can just leave it named new text document. You want to open it up, and in this new text document, you want to go to the description and you'll find this. These are basically codes, right? And what these codes are different amounts of RAM you want to add to your server. So for example, 2 gigabytes, 3 gigabytes, 4 gigabytes of RAM added to your Minecraft server. I would recommend at least 3 gigabytes, if not 2 gigabytes, if you're only running like 4 or 5 plugins. But if you're running more than 4 or 5 plugins and going to have more than like 3 people online, you need at least 3 or 4 gigabytes for your server. And what you're going to do is copy that and paste it over here, and then go ahead and do file save as. And you can then save this as a run.bat file, right? So make sure it says run.bat, and then make sure you change save type as to all files. run.bat is the file name, save type as all files. If you don't do that, it's not gonna work, so then go ahead and click save. Now we can close out of this, we can delete the new text document we created because we don't need that anymore, but we should have a file named run.bat. If we go ahead and double click on run.bat, you will then see this, it'll open up. Can't access jar file bucket.jar. Oh no, why is that? It's because I forgot a part of this step. All we need to do now is come to this jar file right here, right click on it, click rename, and rename it to bucket, and then it should have .jar at the end. Now if yours doesn't have .jar at the end, don't freak out. Yours may just look like this, right? It may just have bucket, and your run file might not have .bat at the end. And if it doesn't, that's okay, because you have file name extensions hidden. If you want to show these, by the way, all you have to do is click on the View tab up here in the top of your Windows Explorer, and then once you do that, come over here and click File Name Extensions. See that button? And boom, it'll make those appear, and now you can see the .jar and .bat file. So as long as this is bucket.jar and that's run.bat, we can double click on the run.bat file, and now we'll go ahead and start loading things up. Now, at first, it should fail here, and as you can see, it has. Press any key to continue, and it should say you need to agree to the EULA, and you should have an EULA text document over here. If you don't, there's two things. Again, make sure that this is bucket.jar, right? You need to show your file name extensions to make sure it's not bucket.jar.jar, because that can happen. So make sure it says bucket.jar there with the file name extensions there. Now, if it does, and it's still not working, you might need to download Java. Luckily, we have a link in the description, which is how to download install Java for Minecraft servers, Minecraft mods, and more. We're starting a Minecraft server, specifically a bucket server. So come here, go through this tutorial, and download Java. It walks you through everything. If you do that, and you still can't double-click on the run.bat file and get it to work, you need the jar fix, which is also linked in the description down below. And this will basically make all the jar files on your computer work with Java once again. So come download that, and it will work. It's helped over 215,000 people fix their Java and their jar files. Now, at this point, we've already double-clicked on the run.bat file, and again, it fails here, saying we need to agree to the ULA. As you can see, you need to agree to the ULA, and we have this ULA.txt. So let's go ahead and open up the ULA.txt here, and then next to ULA equals false, we need to put ULA equals true, T-R-U-E, exactly like that. Now, that is assuming that your Minecraft server isn't going to break the ULA here. This one isn't, so we're good to do ULA equals true. Now, we can go ahead and do file, save, and then double-click on the run.bat file. It'll then go through, download, and install all the things that it needs for a Minecraft server. This could take a while, especially on first startup, but this is when you'll see your plugins folder appear, your world, everything to do with your server will appear in this process. So let's just give it some time to start up. As you can see, it is starting here, 1317. Once that's done, I will meet you after a quick jump cut and continue the tutorial. There we go. As you can see, it does say done right there in the console, meaning it's, well, done starting up. At this point, we can go ahead and stop the server by typing stop in the CMD over here. It'll go through, stop everything, and then you can press any key to continue to close out of that. Now, at this point, we have a server set up, right? You could play on it if you went and typed in your IPv4 address. And I'll show you how to get that here in a second if you want to go test it yourself. But your friends won't be able to join it because we need to port forward in order to allow your friends to join your server. So what you need to do in order to do that is, port forward. We're going to walk through every single step of doing that. Now, if port forwarding does scare you, no worries. We've helped millions of people port forward in the past. However, if it's something you really, really just don't want to do, then Apex Minecraft Hosting is the way to go for you. The breakdown.xyz says Apex. Again, first link in the description down below. You do not need to port forward with this. Their servers. All you do is go over there, get your server, set it to craft bucket, and then from there all you do is get the IP and paste it into Minecraft. It's that simple. There's no port forwarding involved, and that's a way to get around it. However, if you're okay with port forwarding, let's go ahead and get it done. Now what we want to do is come up to the little Windows icon again. It's in the top left for me, bottom left for you, and then we want to type in CMD, right, like so. This will have command prompt here. Go ahead and open up command prompt, and in command prompt here just type ipconfig, ipconfig, all one word, exactly like that, and hit enter. Now it'll go ahead and open up all of this information, and you might be like, that's a lot of information. Nick, do I need all this? No, you just need two things from all this information. We need our IPv4 address, which, again, if you want to start your server and go play on it locally, just take that IPv4 address, type it into Minecraft, like where you would normally type in a server address, and you're good to go. However, if you want to port forward, we will need it for that as well. And then we're also going to need our default gateway. Now, there's two default gateways here. There's this really, really complicated default gateway, as you can see, FE80, 9610, all that stuff, doesn't matter. That's not the one we want. We want the simple one that's just numbers, 192.168.1.1. Should actually start with the same numbers as your IPv4 address. So now let's go ahead and just copy these over into a notepad document. By the way, all of this stuff is in the description of this video. I don't know if I mentioned that earlier, but it is. It's in the description of the video, and you can go down there to get those codes and get those set up. But nevertheless, let's go ahead and type these out. So our IPv4 address is 192.168.1.123. And then our default gateway is 192.168.1.1. Now, yours may be the exact same as mine, your default gateway and everything, and your IPv4 address, but most likely they're completely different, and that's fine. If they're different, if they're the same, that's perfectly fine. That's why we used this method of getting the command prompt and typing in ipconfig to find them. Now we can go ahead and close out a command prompt as long as you have these noted somewhere else, whether it be on a sticky note or like I did in Notepad. Let's go ahead and port forward. Now, the first thing we're going to need is your default gateway. So go ahead and copy that and then open up your browser. In your browser here, you want to open up a new tab. And then in that new tab, just like where you would normally type in breakdowncraft.com, right? Where you would normally type in that, what you want to do is type in your default gateway. So in my case, that was 192.168.1.1, right? Like so. Right, so type in your default gateway there and then hit enter. It will then take you off to a page. Now your page might look completely different from the one that I have here, but that's perfectly fine. All you want to do is it should have a login box, right? Find the login box is what you want to do, and mine is right here. Yours may just pop down from the top of the screen. It might not even open a page. It might just open a login box, but there should be some kind of login box. Now you might be wondering, what do I put in this login box? Well, we have a solution for you. As always, we have an article on how to find your router's password. This goes through 5 different methods of finding the router password or the password to log into your router in order to port forward. As you can see, method 1, method 2, so on and so forth. Most people find their router password by method 4. A few people have to contact their ISP, but if you do that, it pretty much always works. But most people don't need to make it past method 4, and most people can do it with method 2. But nevertheless, with that, you found your router's password, and you can finally log in to your router over here. Now, when you log in, your router will most likely look completely different from my router, and that's perfectly fine. I'm going to walk you through and give you some of the most common tips on what to look for in your router. But don't be scared, right? Don't be scared by all of the buttons and all the different things and all the things you might not like. What is media prioritization? What is, you know, like security? What is security? Connectivity? I don't want to mess anything up. You're not going to mess anything up. Just don't save any changes unless it's involved with port forwarding or NAT forwarding, NAT forwarding. On top of that, we do have an article on our website linked in the description down below with an in-depth video. This video right here will walk you through all of the different routers, the most popular routers on the market, from AT&T to Verizon to even things like Netgear, Cisco routers. All of that stuff is on this video and in this video. And I would recommend watching that even if you don't have a router that's listed in that video, simply because it might not be listed in the video, but a lot of these router companies just use the same software rebadged as their own, which is perfectly fine. But the truth of the matter is, there's probably a software like that in that video if your specific router isn't in that video. So go watch that and it'll help you out. But nevertheless, let's go ahead and get our port forwarding done. So first and foremost, what we want to do on my router is go to security. Now for you, it may be in apps and gaming. It might be in security. It might be in advanced, and then it might be in advanced again. So advanced, advanced. It might be in advanced apps and gaming. It might be in advanced administration. It could be in NAT gaming, NAT gaming. It could be in NAT forwarding, NAT forwarding. There are tons of different names for it, but what you're looking for is port forwarding. So for me, it's in security, and then it's in apps and gaming, and then it is in single port forwarding, right? So quite a few steps for me to get to kind of the end goal here, which is port forwarding. But we found it. We have found port forwarding. Just click around your router. I promise your router has some sort of port forwarding on it. You just need to find it. Now let's go ahead and click add a new single port forward here. You can name whatever you want, right? For you, it might be called an ID, it might be called identification, it might just be name or application name, whatever it is. But I would just put Minecraft in there, that way you know what it is, but it really doesn't matter. Now, for port, this does matter, and whatever it says, no matter what it's called, if it's an external port or an internal port, a port 1, a port 2, an outside port, an inside port, it doesn't matter what it is. If it says the word port, put 25565, right, like so. And what did I say? Guess what? If it says the word port, you're going to put 25565, and this is port as well. It's internal port, so it's going to be 25565. Now for protocol, this is going to be TCP/UDP or both. You want to do both selected in some way. So TCP/UDP, UDP/TCP, or both. If you can't do that, just just do the port forward twice, once for each protocol. Now for device IP, this is going to be your IPv4 address. See, there was a reason we got our IPv4 address back there. And this is going to be our device IP, which is 192.168.1.123. In my case, yours will be different. Now, if you don't have a place to enter in the device IP, it might just be a list, like a drop-down of devices. And if that's the case, select your computer that you're starting the Minecraft server on. Now, at this point, my port forward is done. I can click Save. I can click Apply. It's done. It's over. However, yours may not be. You might have an external IP, and then if you had an internal IP, by the way, that's your IPv4 address. So your external IP is going to be your public IP address. Luckily for all of us, you need your public IP address to join your Minecraft server. So let's go ahead and show you how to find that. And if you don't need it for your port forward, which you most likely don't, 90% of routers these days don't need it, then you're going to be able to get it to join your server. So let's go ahead and click on the What's My IP Address link in the description down below. That's going to take you to this website. Now, on this website, there's some stuff that's blacked out, right? Because you don't want anyone to have your IP address. You want to make sure that it's kept as private as possible and only given to your friends and family and people you trust. That way you don't have to worry about getting, you know, your internet hit offline with a DDoS attack or anywhere else, people finding out where you live, all that stuff. You don't have to worry about it. So as you can see, I'm going to go ahead and copy my IP address here, except the last three digits. But again, you can see all of the information over here on the right-hand side. People can get their latitude and longitude and ordinates, your zip code, all of that stuff is over there and can be grabbed by your IP address. That's why it's very important to only give this to people you trust. And if you do want a public server available to anyone, like our server, play.breakdowncraft.com, you need to go through someone like Apex Minecraft Hosting to do it. And you can check out Apex at the first link down below. But nevertheless, let's go ahead and copy your IP address. Now, if we want to port forward and need a port forward, come over here, paste it in, save your port forward, apply it, all of that stuff. And now we can go ahead and minimize our browser. And we're not done just yet. So we've copied our public IP address. And if you want to like make a note of it over here, you know, you could put your public IP over here. I'm not going to do that because we would have to black it out in the edit and everything. But you could put that up there, the public IP. Just so you know what it is and can like keep track of it. But there's one more thing we need to do before we start our server, and that's go into the server.properties file here. See that? Go ahead and double click on it, and you want to open it with Notepad. You may have to like select Notepad to open it with if it's the first time you've ever opened it. But nevertheless, once you're in here, you want to find server-IP. That's our server IP right there. You want to put your IPv4 address, which is 192.168.1.123. In my case, yours may be different, but whatever it is, your IPv4 address, put it next to server-IP. Go ahead and do File, Save on your server.properties file, and we can finally double-click on the run.bat. At this point, it will go ahead and start our server up over there. We want to then go ahead and open up Minecraft 1.14. I accidentally searched for Minecraft or something like that. I put an O in there. But here is the Minecraft launcher. We're going to go ahead and select version 1.14.4. As you can see, latest release 1.14.4. Click play, and it will go ahead and open up Minecraft for us. As we can see, our server is done starting up over here, and now it's as easy as joining the server. It really is that simple. It's that easy. And yeah, once Minecraft's open, that's exactly what we're going to do. Now, if you do get this, can't keep up, is the server overloaded? That means that you don't have enough processing power or don't have enough RAM on your server. The first thing you want to do is go to the description, get those links, and up your RAM, right? That's the first thing you want to do. If it's still doing that, that means you don't have enough processing power on your computer, and you need to go with someone like Apex in order to fix that. But nevertheless, let's go ahead and direct connect to the server, right like so, paste in our public IP address. But again, you can only see the last three digits of our public IP address. That's need to keep that in mind. And then we can go ahead and click join server. At this point, it will go ahead and connect us on into the server, and we will join right on into it. So as you can see, joining world, boom, there we are. And as you can see, we did join in over here. Player Nix Games has joined in. So there we go. We are now in our server. We are set up and good to go. So one of the things I do want to mention is, what if you can't join your server with your public IP address? If that's the case, most likely you can join it off of your IPv4 address. And if you can, perfect. That's perfectly fine. Go ahead and then give your public IP address to your friends and see if they can join. If your friends can't join off your public IP address, that's when you can have an issue. And the issue is going to be with either your firewall or your port forward. Those are most likely where it's at. It could also be an antivirus, but usually it is a firewall, either on your computer or on your router, blocking the connection. Windows Defender has been known to block Minecraft connections via servers quite often. So make sure that you do allow that in Windows Defender, allow it for Java and all that stuff as well, in order to make sure you can get things rocking and rolling and get your friends joining your server. On top of that, if your friends can join your server and you can't join your server off of your public IP address, just join it off of your IPv4 address and you'll be good to go. Now, Last but not least, how do you op yourself? This is something I always like to tell people is how to op yourself may basically give you all the commands in the game. Well, just go ahead and type in the console, op, and then your username, which is Nick's Game. So OP space, my username, Nick's Games, your username, whatever it is, type it into there and hit enter. And then as you can see, you have made as Nick's Games a server operator. And now we can do things like game mode creative. Now, if you want to go ahead and add to your Minecraft server some plugins, you can check out the eye at the top of your screen. There's also a video on your screen right now that will show you, and like the pop-up, one of the corners of the screen will show you how to add plugins to your Minecraft server, specifically this server we just created using a bucket. So yeah, go check those out to get plugins on your server. My name is Nick. Thank you so much for watching. Give this video a thumbs up, it helped you out. Come play with us on play.breakdowncraft.com for epic survival and incredible skyblock gameplay. But anyway, my name is Nick and I'm out. Peace.